And that was my ticket when they came down the pipe. I snuck into the municipal auditorium, and I got close enough to them to let the security know, hey, I'm here to see Muhammad Ali. And they let me back through those ropes. And when I got to Muhammad Ali, I told the champ, I've been following since I was a little boy. And I hugged him, and I said, I love you, man. And I said, can I be around you when you come back to train? So he allowed me to come to his training camp. And I spent 2 weeks with Muhammad Ali, traveling around New Orleans, going to different projects, children's hospital and everything. And he wrote in the back of my picture of him. This is a picture of him that I have. And this is me with Muhammad Ali when he fought in New Orleans in 1978. I was 29 years old. And he rode to my best friend, Glenn Singleton, from Muhammad Ali's third guard he used to go. At that time, my wife and I was getting ready to build a home. And the end of the home was supposed to be a playroom for the kids. And I told my wife, I said, I got different plans for the room. She said, well, I said, Muhammad Ali, looking at me as his best friend. I said, can I prove to Muhammad Ali that I am worthy of being called his best friend? So what I did, on the corner of the house, I built this showroom, and it says Muhammad Ali Corner. So everything I collected from a little kid, pictures and stuff, is in that showroom. Different memorabilia and everything. And my little girl done a project on Ali when she was in third grade, and she won first place. And I took her to meet Muhammad Ali when she was 12 years old. So what Muhammad Ali blessed me with, to continue carrying his legacy. So what I do, different schools come to my home, so I show the kids, show them. So he blessed me to continue his legacy. So that's what I'm doing. And I like to share this story with you. My wife, we heard about this program. My wife said, you have to do it. I'm just recovering from gastric stomach cancer. And through my process, I was getting all kind of calls from different people. Even got one from Jeannie Cocky telling me that you're going to be all right, Muhammad. And that motivated me. I had a picture of Muhammad Ali at my bedside. And when I rung the cancer bell, let me show something. When I rung the cancer bell, I had to show the world up here that I was being, that I couldn't get defeated by cancer. So this, I presented myself right here. Picture with him and I and Angelo Dundee when they had the Rumble in the Jungle, you know, so all of this stuff is in the show. And I'm just so honored that you give people a chance to come up here to tell their story. And I just love you. That's all I can say.